Hello everyone, welcome to another tutorial from Biology with Shalini, and in this particular tutorial we are going to talk about zymogens, which are basically the digestive enzymes which help in the digestion of all the proteins, carbohydrates, and these are basically produced in their inactive form, and after their activation they carry on the process of digestion. Zymogens are, in simple terms, they are inactive precursors of active enzymes. ATP is not required for the activation. You know, basically what happens that we know that proteins are synthesized by ribosomes, and most of the proteins, when they are synthesized, they are in their active state. They are functional, and their functionality depends on their native conformation, that is three-dimensional forms. But many enzymes or proteins, I'm saying proteins because enzymes are basically proteins, they are made up of proteins. Only some of the enzymes are, very few enzymes are catalytic RNAs, and most of them are proteins. So many enzymes are not synthesized as active enzymes. They need to be activated. There is some specific protein part in that zymogen or inactive precursor which needs to be degraded or which needs to be removed to become functional. So in the case of zymogens, activation is irreversible. And they are activated by proteolytic cleavage. So what is proteolytic cleavage? It is cleavage of one or few specific peptide bonds. As you know that proteins have peptide bonds. So these are a few examples of zymogen activation. Blood clotting factors. Insulin is derived from proinsulin. Proinsulin is basically the zymogen of insulin. And in case of blood clotting factors, I'm sure you guys are aware that there are several clotting factors which are responsible for the formation of ultimate blood clot. So when the first factor, which is the initiator, it gets activated, it gets converted into its active form, then that active enzyme converts another zymogen or another clotting factor into its active part, and the cascade goes on. Similarly, trypsin is initially synthesized in the form of a zymogen, inactive precursor, which is trypsinogen. Chymotrpsin is synthesized as chymotrypsinogen, and carboxypeptidase is synthesized as procarboxypeptidase. Now the question should come, why inactive state? I told you that because of the native conformation, proteins ka active hona, inactive hona depend karta hai. Secondly, to prevent unwanted protein digestion, to regulate proteolytic enzyme, they are synthesized, zymogens are synthesized in inactive state. Suppose most of these zymogens are synthesized in pancreas, and when they get released from the pancreas into the digestive tract or into the gastrointestinal tract, they get activated there only. Look at this thing. Zymogens, when they undergo limited proteolysis, when their active segment, either a dipeptide or any other reason, when it is removed, then they get converted into active enzyme. So this is the whole process. So zymogen, these are the examples. Pepsin is synthesized as pepsinogen. Chymotrpsin is synthesized as chymotrypsinogen. So these are the zymogens, and pancreas is one of the most active organs in synthesizing and secreting proteins. How does it happen? So these zymogens are synthesized in acinar cells of pancreas. Then they are stored in membrane-bound granules of the acinar cells. They accumulate at apex of acinar cells. So when any signal, when any nerve impulse arrives, these hormones, they get released in the gastrointestinal tract. So let's just talk about pepsin first. So pepsin, when it enters, you know, chief cells, parietal cells, these cells are in stomach, and chief cells, they release pepsinogen, and parietal cells, they release HCl. For the activation of this pepsinogen, acidic environment is needed. Remember, there are certain enzymes which needs acidic environment, and there are certain enzymes which needs alkaline environment. Suppose when chief cells release pepsinogen, and this pepsinogen is acted upon by HCl, so this is getting, you know, this is broken down at specific peptide bonds by HCl, and this is converted into slightly active form, which I am denoting it with the help of this star. So this slightly active form of pepsinogen is acting upon this pepsinogen, which is another zymogen. So this pepsinogen, when acted upon, when it is acted upon by this slightly active form of pepsinogen, it will get converted into this pepsin. And pepsin, it is catalytic in nature. This pepsin will now further the cascade of the activation of other pepsin molecules. So this pepsin will eventually act upon other pepsinogen molecule enzyme, and this pepsinogen, this zymogen, will get converted into pepsin. So the process will continue. All right, now trypsin. Trypsin is a proteolytic digestive enzyme. You know, these enzymes, they digest, you know, proteins, carbohydrates. Trypsinogen, when it is secreted, it gets, when it is synthesized in pancreas, you know, so this trypsinogen gets secreted into duodenum. So in the duodenum, what happens? Duodenum is basically anterior portion of small intestine, right? So enterokinase enzyme is there. Enterokinase is, let me explain you with this simple diagram. So here you can see pancreatic duct. So pancreas is forming all the zymogens, and this pancreatic duct is releasing this zymogen into the gastrointestinal tract. So this zymogen will be acted upon by either another enzyme, and this will get converted, this zymogen will get converted into this active enzyme. So suppose trypsinogen, because this is the first enzyme, this is the zymogen which gets converted into trypsin, and trypsin helps in the activation of other enzymes, which I'll let you know later. So this trypsinogen, when it enters the gastrointestinal tract, this is acted upon by this enterokinase. Enterokinase is also called as brush border enzyme, and brush border is nothing but another term for the microvilli. So this enterokinase, it cleaves 6 amino acids from the N-terminus of trypsinogen. Suppose in any protein, this is the N-terminus and this is the C-terminus. So this is trypsinogen, and it will cleave 6 amino acids from the N-terminus. And thus, this after the removal of these 6 amino acids, trypsinogen gets converted into trypsin. So this is all about the activation of trypsinogen into trypsin. Now to answer that, what is the significance of their inactive state? Acute pancreatitis. What happens, like trypsin elastase, phospholipase A2, these are responsible for the degradation for the digestion of proteins. And if they undergo this premature activation, as you know that these are secreted by pancreas, so if they don't get activated in the GI tract or in the duodenum, and instead of getting activated in that place, if pancreas mehi they get activated, then auto digestion of pancreatic tissue happens. Okay, so this medical condition is called this inflammation, this acute pancreatitis. Why this auto digestion of pancreatic tissue happens? Because they are proteases. Their function is to digest proteins, carbohydrates, or when they get prematurely activated, when they are in excess, they start auto digestion of pancreatic tissue. We can call it tissue necrosis also. When they are overstimulated, they can cause excessive blood clotting, which may result from the activation of elastase. So to avoid this situation, trypsin inhibitor is always present in pancreas. So it binds to a specific site in zymogen, makes it inactive, and for the activation of that zymogen, we need to remove this inhibitor. Secondly, self-digestion is also there to avoid such medical conditions. And the fluid secretion by duct cells is also another way to flush out these zymogens. But if gallstone is there and CFTR channels, which are chloride channels, which are responsible for the fluid secretion, if these channels are not working and if the gallstone is there, so this fluid secretion will not happen. To name few inhibitors, there are pancreatic trypsin inhibitor. It blocks trypsin, chymotrypsinogen, by binding to it, and when they are secreted in GI tract, then this inhibitor is removed. And there is one more, which is alpha 1 antitrypsin. It blocks elastase very perfectly. It blocks elastase, it blocks other enzymes like carboxypeptidase, chymotrypsin, elastase, thrombin, plasmin. So this is basically produced in lungs, and this. And when the active forms of these zymogens are present in excess, and if they go to lungs, then this antitrypsin, this binds irreversibly to the target enzyme and makes it inactive. So the necrosis in lungs is avoided, is inhibited. So zymogens are basically the digestive enzymes which are produced in their inactive form. And this is done to avoid tissue necrosis, because they are produced by the pancreas, and if pancreas produces them in their active form, they will certainly digest the pancreas. So to avoid this tissue necrosis, they are produced in their inactive form.
This is all about zymogens, and I hope you guys have understood all the key points about zymogens.